that an intention for this practice this morning? Certainly an opportunity to connect with each other, but certainly an opportunity to remember what today signifies for so many of us here in Parkland, and the 17 that we lost way too soon, too young, too soon. We'll honor them with 17 sun salutations this morning, not in a row. So take a moment and bring your thumbs to the space between the brows, gazing down at the tip of your nose. Just feel some grounding through your feet. Pull your knees up, drop your belly inward, ribs down, and hips up towards the ribs. So we have a nice long spine. On the next inhaling breath, sweep your arms down and up overhead, bringing everything up towards the sky. On the exhaling breath, fold down in between your two legs or hands on either side. And if you're stiff, just bend your knees a little bit. Keep it nice and easy. And then place your fingers or your hands on your shins or on your blocks or stay on the floor, lengthen your spine. And as you exhale, hands down, fold over, head down to your shins. Inhale, look forward again, place your hands where you need, and step to a high plank. Take a breath in here. First time, everybody, lower down knees, chin, and chest to the floor. You can continue doing this throughout. Roll through onto your belly, low cobra, shoulders back, round of the head forward, toes back. As you exhale, have a seat on your heels, tuck your toes underneath you, lift your knees off the floor, downward facing dog. Chest and thighs, you can walk your dog out, take a couple of nice long stretches. And then find a few moments just to settle here, just the first one, first few are gonna be nice and easy and slow. Rise up onto your toes, bend your knees, and take little steps to walk your feet to your hands, top of your mat, however you get there is fine. Feet can be separated or together, empty the breath as you fold down. Let's make this first one like a ragdoll. Roll up through your spine, shoulder stack over, bring the arms overhead, bring prayer to the heart center, exhale. Let's try that again, arms come all the way up, inhale. Exhale, fold through the center, hands to floor, shins, or blocks, hang your head. Halfway lift, place your fingers where they need to be. Exhale, fold, let it go. Inhale, step the opposite foot back, come into your high plank. If you're jumping back, feel free. Exhale, knees, chest, and chin to the floor. Inhale, on your belly, low cobra, elbows hugging, crown of the head, and toes in opposition. Exhale, sit on your heels, tuck your toes, downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Slow the breath, keep it nice and even throughout the entire practice today. And then rise up on your toes, bend your knees, and make your way to the top of your mat. So your navigation of the mat is up to you, how you get there, forward and back. Exhale, fold. If you're adding extra chatter, run those extra push-ups, or go for it. Roll up through the spine, bring the arms up. Exhale, bring the hands to your heart center, arms by your side. Inhale, third one. Exhale, fold through the center, hands to floor, shins or blocks. Inhale, halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, step or jump through a plank. Now, if you'd like to keep your legs straight, go down with straight legs. Upward dog, hi. Downward dog, hips up in the air. Breathe in, breathe out. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Make your way to the top of your mat. Halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Rise up to stand. Bring your arms with you overhead. Bring the prayer to your heart. And let's do that two more times. Inhale, bring the arms all the way up. Exhale, fold through center. Halfway lift, inhale. Step, walk, jump. Bend your knees or go with straight legs down through chaturanga,
all the way through, upward dog, shoulders back and down, heart pulls through. Exhale, downward dog, hips up in the air.
Breathe in, breathe out. Rise on your toes, bend your knees, make your way to the top of your mat, halfway lift. Exhale, let it go. Now ride the breath to stand any way you want to get there. Bring the hands to your heart center. Exhale, one more time. Bring the arms all the way up overhead. We'll just pretend it's an Ashtanga class and we're doing 5 A's. Hang your head down, let it go. Inhale, halfway lift, broaden your collarbones, and make your way through one more vinyasa sequence, coming to your knees or coming through straight leg. Lift your heart up. Downward facing dog, hips up. Breathe in and breathe out. One more round of breath here. On the next exhaling breath, lower your knees to the mat. Make them a little bit wider than your hips. Touch your toes together and find your child's pose. Stretch your arms all the way out in front of you. Spread your fingers, maybe lift them up and place them down one at a time. Move through your hips and just kind of settle in. Let your belly soften in between your thighs. Rise up onto your fingertips, look forward and walk to your right side. Left hand on top of the right, maybe longer than that right arm. Pull your left hip to your heel, relax your shoulders down. Push back to get some length from fingertip to heel. Inhale, rise up. Walk over to the other side. Right arm on top or longer than left. Right hip presses towards the heel. Just relax and breathe. If at any time this gets to be too much for you, just, you know, back off again. Come back to this place and breathe. And then rise back up and make your way back to center. Come back into your child's pose. Inhale. Let's go ahead and sit back on our heels. Bring your knees together. If this is too extreme for your knees, sit on a block or just come into a low squatting position. Bring your arms up over your head. Inhale. Let's take a nice easy spinal twist. Right arm behind left, right behind your body. Left arm to the outside of your right thigh. Drop your shoulders down. Lift your heart up. And then rotate a little bit more. Just let your left shoulder just depress. So just press it downward. And then take the right arm up and lean over to the left side. Keep your hips grounded on your heels. And then right arm's going to come down. Switching the arms. So the right arm stays, the left arm comes behind you, lengthening your spine. Inhale. And exhale, drop your shoulders. Inhale. Left arm's going to come up. Lean up and over to the right side. Just a small little lean, as much as you can get. And then release your arms. Bring your arms up overhead as you rise up onto your shins. Exhale, sit down into child's pose. Legs are close on this one. Inhale, rise up onto your shins. Bring the arms all the way up. Exhale, hands to floor, tuck your toes, find your downward facing dog. Bend your right knee, press your left heel to the floor. Shift the weight into the right arm and the left heel and move your weight out of the right side and the left hand. So there's a little bit more action in that right arm. And then let's do the same thing on the other side. And then see if you can evenly place both the heels of your hands and maybe the heels of your feet to the floor. Chest towards your thighs, biceps by the ears. Inhale. Rise up on your tippy toes. Bend your knees into a turbo dog, chest to your thighs. Shins are close to parallel to the floor, if not, wherever you are comfortable being. Inhale, come back to a hovering tabletop. Push through the heel of your hands, pull your belly in. Lower your knees to the floor. Step your right foot in between your two hands. Help it out if you need to. And then let's rock forward and back a couple times, straightening that front leg. Bring it in, straighten it out. Lift the toes up if that feels good. And just do it a couple times, 3 times, and let's stay back on this straight leg.
on the next breath. My left toes are still tucked under, but they don't have to be. You can just press the top of your foot and shin down. My right knee is pretty bent. My hamstrings are pretty tight. Inhale and exhale. Fold a little bit deeper. Keep the toes up towards the face. On the next breath, we're going to re-bend that front knee. Knee over the ankle, pull your shoulders back, chest down. Good, stretch the arms up over your head, inhaling. Bring your hands together in prayer into your heart center. Good, hold here. Pull back a little bit off of that right leg and a little bit on top of the left knee. Right, a little bit, I shouldn't say on top of the left knee, but a little bit more vertical, right? So press into the right heel and the left shin. Breathe in. Good. Breathe out. Bring the arms back up overhead. Inhale. Exhale. Keep the arms up, but turn your torso a little bit lower. So just reach the crown of your head forward, tailbone back. Keep pressing through that right foot. Hands down. Left hand stays. Right arm up. Tuck the toes under. If you'd like to come up and twist. Hug your hips together towards each other. Keep the weight in that right heel as we just did. In our kneeling position, take another breath. On the exhaling breath, look down. Replace the right hand down. Step to your high plank. Hold your plank, not your breath. And then push your hips up, downward dog. Inhale. Come to that high plank again. Look forward. Lower the right knee. Step the left foot forward. So first settle it in so your knee's over the ankle. You're a little bit off the front knee, the back knee, and then just start moving forward and back a couple times. Take your time, go at your own pace. Good, just start to loosen up, start to get some feeling in there, and then stay back in your straight leg or as straight as your leg wants to go. Maybe the toes come up, maybe they don't. Pull the hips to the center, breathe, and empty out, let everything go. Hang out here. Find a place that you can settle into where it's not too uncomfortable so you lose your breath, where it's not too easy that you hyperextend your knee, so find some action. And then take the next breath to fold forward, bend that left knee again. Good. And then place your hands on your thighs just for a moment. Just come up so that you back off a little bit off of this or are getting more vertical again. Bring the arms up overhead. Drop your shoulders down. Now, so push into your left heel, and you should feel that right top of the foot and shin pressing down to keep you active here. Bring hands to your heart center. Feel that left hip nice and active, the left glute pushing down into that left heel. Rise up nice and tall. Breathe in, breathe out. One more big breath. Good, bring the arms up. As you exhale, just tilt a little forward. Bring the right hand down, left arm up and twist. Right toes can stay down, or right knee can stay down. Right toes can tuck under and you lift up. Crown of the head towards the front, hips move in towards each other. Can you lift your belly off your thigh? Can you pull that right knee up if you are in the lunge with your right leg straight? Breathe in, breathe out. One more time, big breath. Find a little bit more twist. As you exhale, empty down, hand to the floor, look forward. Right foot this time steps to left foot, top of the mat. Exhale, fold and grab opposite elbow. Sway a little bit side to side, bend your knees as much as you need to. And then just switch the cross of the arms. Settle in when you're ready. Find all four corners of your feet grounding you. Head hangs down, pelvic floor muscles up, belly to spine, chin to chest. Release your arms as you grab the elbow, stand all the way up. Roll your shoulders back and around. Heel toe your feet together. Bring your arms up overhead. Inhale. Bring prayer to the heart. Exhale. Inhale. Bring your arms up overhead. Exhale. Forward fold. Second set of sun salutations. Halfway lift. Inhale. Exhale. Walk or step through your chaturanga or go to your knees. Add push-ups. Take what you need. Leave the rest behind. Downward dog. Couple breaths. Inhale. And exhale. High on your toes. Bend your knees. Look forward. Make your way to the top of the mat. Halfway lift. Exhale. Fold. You come to
standing the way that suits your body. Bring the arms all the way up. Bring the hands to your heart. Bring the arms by your side. Second one, arms all the way up.
Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Use what you need. Exhale, walk, step, or jump to the back of your mat. Take your vinyasa your way. Adding push-ups, taking away push-ups. And we meet in downward dog to relax back. Catch the breath. Inhale and exhale.
Good.
Inhale, look forward. Make your way to the top of the mat. Halfway lift, inhale. Empty out, exhale.
Ride your breath to stand all the way up. Hands down to center, arms by your side. Inhale, bring the arms up.
Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, walk or jump through chaturanga. All the way up through your up dog. Downward dog, hips up. Couple of breaths just to bring us back. High on your toes, bend your knees, make your way to the top of your mat. Halfway lift. Empty the breath, let it go.
Ride the breath to stand all the way up. Bring the prayer down to your heart. Exhale.
Arms by your side. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Two more just like this.
Halfway lift, inhale.
Exhale, walk or jump back. Take it through your flow. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog.
Breathe in. Breathe out. See how unintimidating these five at a time are.
Rise onto your toes, bend your knees, look forward, make your way to the top of your mat, halfway lift. Exhale, let it go. Stand tall, bring your arms with you.
Hands to your heart, arms by your side. Last one in this sequence, arms all the way up.
Exhale, fold all the way down.
Halfway lift, inhale.
Last time, Chaturanga Dandasana, not of the day, just of the sequence, this little block of vinyasa. Downward dog, hips up, stay here with your breath.
Inhale and exhale. Bring your feet a little closer together.
Rise up onto your toes. Bend your knees, chest to your thighs. Parallel your shins to the floor. Push away with the heel of your hands.
Inhale, shift to a high plank. A tabletop hovering.
Then a high plank. Legs straighten. Push back, downward dog, right leg in the air. Right leg steps through. Feel free to lower your knee to the floor or rise up to crescent lunge. Bring your arms with you overhead. Inhale and exhale.
Now bend that back knee. Come a little bit lower to the floor. Some of you will get really close. So as you drop your hips down, right, stay square. Keep pulling that right hip in, left hip in. Everything meets to the center. Now, as you drop down through that, straighten your leg and stay that low. Arms up, inhale. And exhale. Bring your ribs towards your hips. Pull your belly to your spine. Tuck your tailbone underneath you. Now reach your arms forward. Tilt your torso forward. Release the left arm down as the right arm comes up. Back into that twist. Hug the hips towards midline. Breathe. Inhale. Don't forget about that back leg, guys. It's nice and strong. As you exhale, hands down inside that right leg. Turn your left toes on the side, pull your hip in, and take the left arm. Shoulder step, hips pull in, look down at your toes, rise up on warrior two on your left side. Back. Straighten arms and legs, rebend, come back into your warrior two. Let's do that one more time, inhale. And bring it in, exhale. Last time, inhale. Bring the hands into your prayer. Hold it here. So pull back a little more with your left arm, pull forward a little more with your right arm. Have your shoulders in the same line or your hands in the same line. Lift up your right heel, sit a little bit lower. See what that changes in your body. Does it change anything or is it just, all right, my heel's off the floor, no big deal. Breathe, find some strength in that right leg. Exhale, place the foot down. Inhale, turn your palms, reach forward. Left arm down, right arm up. lift up and over. Put your left hand on your hip to allow it to move towards the right knee. So you have a little bit more side bend. Try the same thing. Lift the right heel off the floor again. Inhale. Exhale one more time, please. Lower the heel. Rewind your arms to the floor. Step back through vinyasa. Settle in. Skip it. Add to it. That's just to clear the slate, right? It's not counting in our 17, by the way. Breathe in and breathe out. Good. Feet together. Left leg nice and high. Look between your hands and step it on through. Good. Come to your fingertips and settle in. And then make your way to your crescent lunge. Arms up. Reach. You don't have to touch your hands together. Mine tend to touch. But I have my shoulders are a little bit open there. Now bend the back knee as much as you can. So all you're doing is dropping down with your pelvis. But now straighten the back leg and stay that low. Arms are all the way up. Inhale. Ribs towards hips, shoulders down, away from your ears. And now go ahead and tilt forward. Reach, reach, reach. And then take the right arm down, left arm up for your twist. Hug your left hip in. Pull your right knee up, crown of the head forward. Tailbone back. Inhale. And exhale. Big breath. As you empty the breath, left hand's coming down inside. Right foot turns on its side. Hug that left hip into midline. Right arm is up. Breathe. Look down at your left toes. And make your way to warrior two as you exhale. Settle in. Three pumping warriors. Arms and legs straighten. Exhale. Rebend. Two more times. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Hold. Reach back. Now we refine it, right? So now we have the right arm pulling back, the left arm pulling forward, the hips opening away from each other while the heels go towards each other. And now once again, lift your left heel off the floor. So start to feel where do you notice that, right? Do you notice it in your quads, just your calf? Or you don't notice it at all and it's fine, you can do this all day long. Take another breath. Lower the left leg, flip your palms, reach forward. Right arm down, left arm up as we reverse our warrior. Put your right hand on your hip and guide it towards the left knee without coming out of the left knee. So keep that left knee bent. Breathe in and breathe out. And if you can, lift the left heel up again. Good. You don't have to change the height of your body at all. One more breath. Good. Release and rewind. Hand down. Step back to a high plank. Take your flow or go right back to downward facing dog. We all meet in dog or child's pose if that's good for you. Breathe in, breathe out. Rise up onto your toes, bend your knees, look forward. Make your way to the top of your mat, halfway lift. Inhale. And exhale. Good, rise all the way to standing. Bring your hands to your heart center. Inhale, bring your arms all the way up overhead. Exhale, fold through center. Halfway lift, inhale. Walk or step through vinyasa. Exhale. This is number 11. Lift your heart up. Downward dog, hips up in the air. Breathe in, breathe out. High up on your toes, bend your knees, make your way back to the top of your mat. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, let it go. Ride your breath to stand all the way up, inhale. Exhale through prayer to the side. Bring the arms back up overhead. Exhale, fold down. Hang your head. Halfway lift. Exhale through vinyasa. Good. Remember, if the vinyasas become too much for you, skip them and go right to dog or child's pose. This is number 12. Breathe in and breathe out of 17 that we will be doing today. Rise on your toes, make your way to the top of your mat, halfway lift. Empty the breath, exhale. Rise and standing all the way up. We're going to do one more of these as you bring your hands to your heart center. Arms by your side. Last one right now. Inhale. Last spoon of the block, hang your head down, hands to floor, shin to blocks. Halfway lift, inhale. Make it through your vinyasa, your way. Add, skip,
Do you. Stay in downward facing dog. Breathe in
and breathe out. We've made it through 13 dedicated vinyasas. We've had a few even in between. Bring your feet together. Take your right leg in the air. Lift high on your left toes. Now open your right hip. Bend your right knee. Pull the heel towards the buttocks. And this time, keep both arms carrying the weight rather than just that left arm. Let that leg fold back. And then turn your body square. Stay in dog as you bring your right knee to your chest. Look forward and step it through. Turn your back foot on its side. Windmill open, warrior two. Exhale. Right heel lifts. Inhale, flip your palms. Reach forward, left arm down, right arm up. So our heel is up. Move that left foot towards the right knee. Breathe in. Take that nice side bend. Now lower your heel. Straighten your leg. Come up to standing. Reach the right arm forward. Reaching out as far as you can. Triangle pose. Trikonasana. Right arm down. Left arm up. Breathe. Spin your heart up and spin your shoulders back and down. Pull your knees up and in. Good. Beautiful, guys. Stay there, stay strong. Inhale and exhale. Rise up, reverse that triangle one more time. Turn your right toes to the left side, one quarter turn. Bring your arms behind your back. Interlace your fingers, wrists, elbows, forearms, or a reverse prayer. So depending on your shoulders and how they're feeling today. Turn your toes slightly pigeoned. Lift your heart up against your arms, lift your heart. And then as you exhale, come forward. Stop halfway in tabletop. Crown of the head to the tailbone. Breathe in and breathe out. Good. Bring your collarbones forward, shoulders back. Can you squeeze your shoulder blades together on your back? Keep that action as maybe you fold down in between your legs. Fold down, not fall down. Sounded like I said fall. One more breath here. Let the crown of the head reach towards the floor. Let your hands release underneath your shoulders. Rise up onto your fingertips. Left hand in the center of your mat, right hand to your sacrum. So lengthen out the top of the head to the sacrum nice and long. And then rotate your torso first. Stack your shoulders if you can. The tendency is to kind of shift into that right leg a little bit more. So we're going to try to stay even. So we might not get, I like to say, as much satisfaction out of the twist, but you'll keep the hips level for this one. And if you have a block, this is a great place for it, yeah? So if you're feeling tight, you can bring yourself up on the block. And then see if that right arm wants to come up. And as you do that, draw that right hip back towards midline. Draw that left leg towards midline. Again, you might not get as much satisfaction into the twist as you would if you moved your hips off center. Nice, guys. Come back to center and switch to the other side. Left hand down. Or right hand down, excuse me, left hand to the hip. Lengthen your spine first, find the length. Then rotate your torso. And then take your left arm up in the air. Now hug that left hip towards the midline. So the hard part is not swinging off your hip to the other side. I'm not saying it's wrong. It's not what we're doing today. As you exhale, let it come back down. Hang your head, let it go. Inhale, move your block away if you've used it. Creep yourself around to the front of your mat. Step back to a downward facing dog, hips up in the air. You want to take an extra vinyasa? Go for it. Bring your feet together. Left leg up in the air. Bend your knee as much as you need to on that right leg, and then bend your left knee. Bring your heel towards your buttocks, and keep your weight evenly distributed in both arms. Right? Otherwise, you would be taking it over into another pose. Keeping the knee bent, turn your hips square, ground your back. Look forward and step that left leg through. Spin your right foot on its side. Warrior two, inhale and exhale. Good. Now lift your toe, your heel up, excuse me. Flip your palms, reach forward, and reverse your warrior here. Take your hip and move it towards the knee without changing anything in your pelvis or the height of your legs, right? Breathe in. Good, lower the leg, straighten the leg, rise up to standing facing the right side of your mat, and shift forward with your torso as far out as you can. And then take the left arm down, right arm up. Trikonasana, triangle pose. Can you lift from the bottom side of your body so you're not collapsing into your waistline? Pull your knees up so you're strong and stable in your legs, right? And we're not using all these accessory muscles and areas to take the weight of our body, right, and the brunt of our weight. Take another breath. Look down, return to your reverse triangle pose. Good, and now take it back to standing, left toes turn in. Take your arms the same way you did. If you interlace your fingers, take the different interlacing and take it into a nice tabletop position. So crown of the head, tailbone in the same line. Bring your collarbones forward, shoulders pull back. Now squeeze your shoulder blades together on your back. Breathe in, adjust yourself if you need to make shorter or wider in your legs. And then if you can maintain that long spine, fold down in between your legs, let your head hang down. Breathe, inhale, and exhale. One more breath. Good, just stay down, but release your hands. Come to your fingertips, lengthen your spine. Bend your right knee. Take your left hand to your right foot. Right hand to your sacrum, rotate to the right side. And then maybe that right arm stretches up. Keep your weight back into your right heel so your hips move back. Breath in. And as you exhale, straighten your right leg. Look down. Take your right arm underneath towards wherever you can get. I can only get to my thigh. Some of you can get to the other ankle. And then pull yourself towards center. Hang your head down. And then gently release left arm, right arm, lengthen your spine. Bend your left knee and sit into your left hip. So it's a skandhasana, but you don't have to drop all the way down. We're just working on a twist. Take your right hand to your left ankle, left hand to your sacrum. Rotate your torso. Keep your weight back in your left heel. And then take your left arm up. Breathe. So now that we've got our hips off center, we might have a little bit more satisfaction into the twisting. And if you can, straighten your leg. Good. As you exhale, look down. Bring the left arm under the right. And grab where you can, as long as it's not your knee. Or maybe adjust your left arm up a little higher so you have a little bit more of an even cross. It's up to you. Inhaling, release the hands to the floor. Lengthen your spine. Take a little crawl to the front of your mat. Step back into a downward facing dog. Hips up in the air. Feel free to take vinyasas where you want. Come forward to a high plank on this one. Lower your hips down so it's like an upward dog, but our knees are down, shoulders are back away from the ears, so we're just kind of stretching to the front hips. Good. Breathe in. Have a seat on your heels. Release your arms by your side. Turn your palms up towards the sky. Drape your shoulders open over your thighs. Bring your hands towards your knees. Rise up onto your toes. Sit back on your heels. And let your knees open and walk your hands forward. Heels can touch together. Pull your belly into your spine, round your back. Let everything relax. Good. Keeping your arms on the inside of your knees, walk them back so that the knees are hugging in. Lift up onto your toes. You can stay right here. You can lift 1 foot, maybe 2 feet. Maybe you come into a full crow, both feet together, working your heels towards your buttocks. If you're just starting with this, just try to work one leg at a time off. Some of you will take your option of bringing your knees right underneath your triceps or underneath your underarms rather than outside of your arms. That's right also. Okay, some of you are working at straightening your arms, and some of you might be even working into headstands and other variations from there. So I want you to take whatever is working for you today, and then we're going to come back to the floor when you're done, back into that low squat, work your arms out. My feet are a little bit wider on the second one. Good. And then walk your hands in enough that you can straighten your legs and turn your toes forward. Walk your legs out side to side. And then come back to center and just fold over. Come to your fingertips, lift your toes up off the floor and slide your hands underneath your feet so you can wrap your big toe around your wrist. Look up, inhale. And exhale, elbows out to the side, head to the shins. Send your weight a little forward. It might feel like you're coming down. So just find some stability through your core center. Push and pull at the same time. Breathe. Halfway lift, inhale. Release your hands from your feet. Place your hands at your hips and rise up to stand. Heel toe your feet together. Bring your arms up overhead. Bring your hands to your heart as you bring your right leg off the floor. Stay even on your both sides. Extend the leg, reach the arms up. Take it forward, stepping forward, charging your body into warrior three. Breathe, point your toes back, crown of the head forward. Hips are square. Press. You can bend the standing leg as much as you want or need to, but find stability in it, right? So spread your toes, make your foot nice and strong and powerful. Looking great, guys, good. Breathe in. Now stand up and bring the left knee to your chest. Extend your leg and arms, lift up. Step forward, hands to prayer, and we charge forward, point your toes. Dip your belly, arch your back. Point your toes back, crown of the head forward. Try to level off your hips, breathe in, breathe out. And then come on back to center, bring your feet together. So if you're not at the top of your mat, take a few steps until you are. Inhale, arms down by your side, exhale. Inhale, bring the arms up overhead. Exhale, fold through center. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, walk or jump through vinyasa, number 14. Lift your heart up. Downward dog, hips up in the air. High up on your toes, bend your knees. Make your way to the top of your mat. Halfway lift. Exhale, let it go. Rise to stand, bring your arms with you. Exhale, hands to your heart. Release the arms one more time. Number 15, arms up. Exhale, forward fold, hang your head, let it go. Halfway lift, inhale. Vinyasa, exhale, your way. Upward and downward facing dogs. Breathe, inhale, and exhale. Walk your hands to your feet, back of the mat, once again. Hang your head, let it go. Rise to stand. Hands to your heart, come up to standing all the way. Heel toe your feet together. Inhale, bring your arms overhead. Exhale, bring your hands to prayer as you lift the right leg up. Good. Open your right knee to the right side. If you need help, place it above or below the knee, tree pose, vrikshasana. So squeeze your left hip into midline, squeeze your foot into your inner thigh. Take the arms up overhead, inhale. Hug that left hip nice and strong in. Right arm down, left arm up and over. Little balancing, dancing tree. Rise up. Hands to your heart. Right leg comes forward once again. Extend the right leg forward. Step it down to the floor and square off your hips so that you're not on a tightrope. Your hips are, or your feet are hips width apart. Your shoulders and hips are squared. Take a breath in. Pull your knees up nice and strong, mat back. And then come down halfway. Halfway, halfway. Blocks are very helpful here, so if you have one, grab it nearby. Place it inside or outside of that right leg. Place your right hand on your sacrum, lengthen your spine, and then rotate. I have to widen my feet a little bit. As you twist to the right side, stack your shoulders, hug your hips into midline. And again, maybe that right arm comes up. Twisting, cleansing, detoxifying, giving our spine some juice. Big breath in. Make sure both big toes are planted on the floor. Breathe in. Good. Square off your hips.
One more breath. Place it anywhere but your knees, so just check out the knee joint, guys. And then if your hand is on a block, take that block in your hand. If not, just you're going to come up. Rise up. Bring the arms up. Good. Bring both arms together. Turn around to face the back of your mat. Take the block in the right hand. So for those of you, I'm sorry for my back side, but you'll be able to hopefully tell my hips are hopefully going to be square. Shoulders, hip points point forward, left hand on your back. Lengthen your spine. So again, start coming halfway down. Start with the crown of the head and the tailbone in the same line. Breathe in. Good. And now take the arm inside or outside of the foot. Nice, Michelle. Good. Beautiful. Shoulders stack. So some of us have to widen our stance. Widen both in length and in width. Right? And then rotate. And maybe, you know, maybe the shoulders are stacking. Maybe the hips are square. Breathe in, breathe out. One more big breath. Exhale, let it fold. If you have the block, take it in your hand, rise up, turn back to face the front of the room, bring your hands together. You can take the block off to your side, feet together. Bring your hands to your heart, bring your left leg off the floor. I bet you thought I forgot. Open that left knee to the side, hug the right leg in, and help place that left foot somewhere. Maybe it's above your knee, maybe it's below your knee, maybe it's on the floor. Once you get there, hug that right hip inward so you really have the stability of that right foot. And then perhaps take your left hand to the left knee and lean your tree over. And now rise up. Hands to your prayer. Left foot down. We're going to step down. Left foot, right foot to the top of the mat. Arms by your side. Inhale, arms all the way up. Empty the breath, fold down. Halfway lift, inhale. Step through vinyasa, exhale. Inhale. And exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe. Rise up on your toes, bend your knees, make your way to the top of your mat, halfway lift. Empty the breath, let it go. Rise to standing, bring the arms all the way up overhead. Bring your hands to your heart center. Take a moment here, our final of our 17 vinyasas today. Our 17 vinyasas honoring the 17 from Douglas 3 years ago. Open up your eyes, send peace and love. Healing thoughts out to the universe. Bring your arms up way over your head. Exhale, fold.
Halfway lift, inhale.
Make your way through this vinyasa. Take your time. Breathe into it. Breathe life into it. Lift your heart up. Find yourself in downward facing dog. Breathe.
Chest towards your thighs. Everything hangs. Breathe in and out. And then bring your knees to the mat.
Sit back on your heels, child's pose. Bring your arms by your side. Kick your palms up to the sky. Take a moment of peace here. A little bit of a release. And you did 17 vinyasas like it was nothing. So maybe we will visit the 108 one day soon.
Drape your shoulders open. Let it go. Rise to sit on your heels.
Once again, rise up onto your shins, bring your arms with you. Bring the prayer to the heart center. Separate your knees. Good. Bring your hands onto your hips. Pelvis tilts forward. So elbows, your fingers could be in either direction. Elbows come in, lifting your heart. I just want you to stay here for a moment. So I just want you to get into whatever that bend is for you here without collapsing into your lower back. So think about lifting up out of your pelvis and over, lifting the middle and upper back up. Your hands can be supporting your back, elbows squeezed together. Breathe in, breathe out. Exhale, sit on your heels, release your hands to the floor.
Now, Jane, I know you love this one. Everybody, widen your legs a little bit more.
Take your hands on top of your heels. Maybe watch me once. I'll just demonstrate
quickly for those of you not sure. So we're in a child's pose, but we're grabbing our heels, so we're going to come into a rabbit pose. So the hips are going to lift up off the heels. The back is rounded. And then we flip the angle of our hands as we lift up and we find our full camel. Now, if full camel is not in the cards for you today, take one hand to your foot, come up to kneeling, take one hand to your foot, one hand up. But if you want to try a little funky coming from rabbit into camel, it's quite satisfying once you get it. But your knees need to be a little bit wider, most likely. Hands on top of the heels, cupping the heels.
So you rise up onto your shins. No weight in your head, right? There's pressure in the top of the foot and shin, not your knees, not your head. And then roll yourself up as if you were going into a rounded spine, head off the floor. And then you might have to flip your wrists a little bit as you lift up and then push your hips forward, right?
So we have to change the positioning of our hands, of our spine. Once you get up into the pose, you have to bring your hips forward and arch your back. If you want the other options, maybe you just take a hand to heel on each side. Now coming down is not quite as easy, so we're gonna just take our hands to our hip, our heart, come all the way up, and sit back in child's pose, arms out by your side, let your head go. And because it is Valentine's Day and we wanna open our heart, we'll do one more with ease.
All right, so grab a hold of your heels.
Again, if you're starting from your camel, go up into your shins and start that way.
If you'd like to try the funky variation, round your back, push the top of your foot and shin to the floor, roll up through your spine, adjust your arms, pull your hips back, and then push them forward.
Maybe your head drops back as well. So this is all, you know, very individual how we get there, how we maintain it, what works for us here. When you're ready to come out of it, hands to your heart, and then have a seat back in child's pose. This time extend your arms all the way in front of you. And then come up to your knees and just take your legs off to either side, and we'll just swing our legs around to the front of the mat. Take a little, my way, Jacqueline Asana to the front of your mat. And then today, just separate your legs the width of your mat, short edge of your mat. So we're not in a wide upavista, we're just from the short edges of the mat right here. Fingers down on the floor to bring your shoulders back and down, collarbones up, chest forward. Inhale. Thank you. Exhale. Good. Reach the arms up overhead. Inhale. Reach out of your waistline. Exhale, open your arms out, thumbs up to the sky, fingers are nice and spread. Now rotate to the right side like you're going to do a water wheel. And then you're going to take your left arm to your right outside of your right foot. So it may only be outside your thigh or maybe outside your calf. Or some of you might actually get to the outside of the toe without adjusting this left hip off the floor, right? So stay grounded. Left arm down, maybe the right arm comes up. Maybe the right arm binds behind your back to your left leg. And turn your ear towards your left knee, right knee, excuse me. One more breath. If you have a hold of your foot, pull against it, lengthen your spine, everybody. If your right arm is down, bring it back up. Rise back up into your water wheel, and then come back to center. Open your arms out. Inhale, rotate to your left side. So it's like, a scissor in Pilates. Turn yourself to the left side, reach out, right arm's going to grab wherever it can except for your knee. Maybe the left arm comes up or maybe it binds behind your back. Either way, work at turning your torso without lifting that right hip off the floor. Right ear towards your knee. Keep finding the grounding of that right hip there, right? Keep finding that sitting bone down on the floor. Don't lose that connection. Inhale, release your arm back, Rise up, pull that final toe, or that final tug, come back up, and then everything faces forward. Reach the arms all the way up. Exhale, lean your torso forward, keep the crown of the head, tailbone in the same line, reach through your heart, and then reach down as far as you can go with a straight spine, place the hands on the floor. Some of you will come very far down. Some of you will be more like me and not quite as far. I think Michelle Hines can get pretty far down. I think all my Michelles can. Breathe. So more about not folding your head to the knees or to the floor, not worrying about so much about that, but stretching out from the back side of the body. Legs are very active, aren't they? Yeah, pull the toes up, pull the knees up. And then take a breath and reach a little further with your hands now coming off the floor. And then rise all the way up. Keep your legs active, pull your knees up, toes to your face. Chin to chest, we're gonna roll down through our spine this way. Pull the belly in, take your time. Lay down on the floor. Take your arms in the same position as your legs so you have a giant X on the floor. And now let the legs go. Ding dong, somebody's back. Breathe in, breathe out. Cross left ankle over right ankle. Take your left hand with your right and create a crescent shape. Relax the feet. Stretch the left side of the body long while there's compression on the right side of our body. Maybe a lot, maybe a little for some. Can you soften the right glute and the right foot? And then release both of the binds, arms back, the legs back to that X shape. Right leg crosses over left ankle, left arm grabs the right arm, and now we lengthen out the right side of our body and compress into the left side. Just relax the shoulders, relax the glutes, relax the feet. Your binds, separate your legs, separate your arms, let your body melt into the mat, let go. Bend your knees and place the feet on the floor, and then take the soles of the feet together and take the knees apart. Take your hands now inside of your thighs and roll the thighs open. Together, elbows out. Now bring your left knee to your right knee. Bring yourself all the way onto your right side. Take your left arm longer than your right. Keep your knees bent. And then sweep that left arm back and open into your twist. Now for some of you, you will be able to bring your knees a little higher to your shoulders and chest. And get a little deeper into that twist. Some of you will have to back it off a little bit, maybe even putting a block between your legs or underneath your legs. So this is a deeper stretch. Let go. Take the left leg and open it back up. Baddha Konasana, Supta Baddha Konasana. Now take your right knee to your left knee and take your right arm to your left arm. So you're just resting on your left hip now. Reach that right arm long and then sweep it back and around as you come into that spinal twist. So make whatever adjustments you need to make for your body that allows you to settle into this placement, right? Take the right leg back up, soles of the feet together.
Supta Baddha Konasana. Bring your arms across your chest, one on top of the other. Grab a hold of your shoulders from underneath. And just give yourself a big hug. And while you're giving yourself a big hug, see if you can pull your arms away from each other. Open the arms up. Cross the opposite arm over. Grab a hold of your shoulder blades. Pull yourself close. And then open the arms a little wider. And then gently release. Take your arms and bring your knees together. Hug the knees into the chest. Grab a hold of the top of the foot, shin, or ankle. And round your spine as your head and shoulders lift up. Lay down on your backs. Bring your legs in the air. Separate your legs. Let them just kind of hang there for a moment. Not too wide. Yeah, everybody bring it a little closer. Just a little bit. So don't think of a split. Just think about having your feet maybe about hips width apart, maybe not even that far. So again, allow your weight, the weight of your body, whatever it is on the floor, to just melt into the floor. Your legs might start to shake. Bring your ribs down to your hips and your belly down to your spine. Bring your feet together. Point your toes to the sky. Take your arms in the air, right over your shoulders. Reach your head and shoulders up towards your toes. And if you have one more little bit of energy here, lift your hips up off the floor. So it's enough to really compress that center bottom of our body without holding your breath. Breathe in and out. And as you exhale, come down. Hug your knees into your chest. Take a quick little happy baby pose with your hands wherever they feel right for you today. You know, I could tell you where to place your hands and your feet all the time. It might not be right for you, and you can say, I don't like that, so I'm not going to do that pose, you know? So I want you to feel where it's right for you. Just keep the in mind that your tailbone should stay down, that your knees should come back towards your shoulders. And the rest is kind of gravy. Come back to center. And then once again, release. If you can hold onto your toes, great. Bring your legs together and straighten the arms and legs back up to the ceiling. This time our hips are down on the floor. We're going to bring the arms down by the side. Some of you might prefer to bring your hands underneath your hips. And then first find that L shape on the floor. So your body is on the floor, your legs are 90 degrees over your hips. And then point your toes and really make your legs very strong. Try to squeeze everything together and long at the same time. And as you start to exhale, lower the legs. At the same time as you lower the legs, you're lengthening the legs away from you. Take your hands or keep your hands down where they are. Take your time. Those last 45 degrees, gravity just wants to pull you right down to the floor, so work against it. When you finally get the heels to the floor, roll up onto your forearms and give yourself that heart opener. Open your throat, your chest. Breathe again. You should have full breathing capacity here. Breathe and open. Some of you have other poses that you choose to take in this variation. And then when you're ready to come out of it, chin to chest, lower your back down and once again hug your knees into your chest. Take a simple spinal twist. Or just rock and roll your legs from side to side. Make sure you do both sides. Knees into the chest. One more time. Big rounded spine. Everything comes off the floor together. Take a breath in as you empty the breath. Release your legs to the floor. Release your arms to your side. Take a few moments here just to scan your body. Start at the top of your head. Come to the forehead. The bridge.
bridge of your nose, the tip of your nose, your eyelashes, your eyelids, your cheeks, your tongue, your lips, your throat, your jaw, your ears, your chest, your collarbones, shoulders relaxed, neck, front and back of the arms, the elbows are soft, the forearms, the fingers, the palms, the wrists, the belly, the upper mid and lower back, the pelvis, the quadriceps, the hamstrings, the knees are soft, the calves and shins, the ankles, the feet, the toes. And the thoughts inside of your head are still. There will always be thoughts coming in and out. It's what we do to those thoughts, to carry them on, or do we just let them go? So right now, just take a cleansing breath to release the thoughts in your mind. Empty out and heavy yourself into the mat. Slowly start to deepen your breath. Start to introduce movement back into your fingers, your toes, your wrists, your ankles. Feel free to stay longer if you can, or begin to make your way onto either side, resting for a moment, and then bringing your way back up into a comfortable seated position. Bring your hands to your heart center when you get there. Thank you so much today for joining me, in particular on this day, honoring our town, our little town. 17 sun salutations. Thank you for indulging me and for yourselves. Thank you for all the strength that you give to the community, to myself in particular. Om Shanti, 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 Om peace, peace, peace to all. I bow down and honor the beauty, the light, the love, the peace within each one of you. Namaste, Satnam. Go in peace. My friends at home, stay home, stay fit, stay healthy.